Hey guys, I'm going to show you how to make this a Farmhouse Farmer's Market sign that's perfect for fall. So I apologize, but I pre-stained these paint sticks with antique wax stain, and then I'm just gluing them together on the video. On the right, you can see the pieces. I was going to try to make like a picket fence, but then I decided to use the crate that you'll see later that I picked up from the Dollar Tree instead because my fence wasn't laying properly and it was driving me crazy. So again, I pre-stained the wood with the antique wax and then attached it and also attached some other pieces of the wood to the back. Here I'm just sanding the wood down because you can't go wrong with sanding. I love sanding everything down to give it that distressed look. Also I think it makes it look distressed. I'm just getting my stencil ready. This is my brand new stencil from Magnolia Design Company. I think it's adorable, the farmer's market with the floral. As you can see on the wood, the color looks a little different because I just took a white chalk. I actually used the chalk paste from Magnolia Design and just did a light finish with a sponge to give it that like weathered look on the, the brown I think was looking a little too brown for me for what I was going for. So that's why I did that. What I'm doing here is just using the Minwax finishing wax, which I'll show you in a second, right there. It helps the paint go on smoother and it helps so the stencil doesn't stick too much to the wood. You want it to stick, but not too much. Now I'm just applying my chalk paste. You can see how easy it is to use these stencils. And the best part is they're reusable. They're incredible. So really, really simple. Just put a little bit. A little bit goes a really long way. You can see I'm just putting the white on the words, and don't worry about it if you get it on the sign. As you can see, I'm kind of a messy crafter. I get it all over my hands. If you get it on another piece of the sign, no big deal because you can wipe that off, and you'll see me do that actually when I take the stencil off. I'm just using that yellow, I think it's called daffodil, but I forget. Yellow color for the flowers, and then you'll see I'm going to use a blue color on the truck. And you'll see all I'm doing is just using the rubber squeegees. Magnolia Design Company makes these rubber spatulas, mixing tools, squeegees. I highly recommend mixing your chalk paste before you apply it to the stencil, making sure it's the right consistency. If it's looking too thick for you, you can add a tiny, tiny bit of distilled water. I didn't need to do that here. These are rather new jars I have here. So they're the perfect consistency for me. You really just need a thin, thin layer, and make sure that it's a thin layer and you can see the stencil through your chalk paste. So you'll see how much I just put a tiny bit of the paste on and then really just spread that thin with the spatula. Okay, and I'm lifting my stencil off here. When you lift off the stencil, just make sure that you're going either up and down fully or side to side. Don't go diagonal. You can ruin the stencil and stretch the stencil that way, and you want to be able to reuse it. All right, so you're going to see now I'm just wiping. I've sprayed a little bit of water on my microfiber cloth, and I'm just wiping a little bit of the excess white I got above the stencil there. Comes right off. Showing you my beautiful work. All right, so now here are some items I picked up at the Dollar Tree. This is just some floral foam, shoving on in that box. And really it was just to fill space. You really could use anything. You really didn't need to use the foam. Sunflowers, these mini pumpkins are adorable. All this from the Dollar Tree. I got these little moss balls thinking I'd use them, but then I realized that pumpkin patches usually have hay, not moss. So I went with the, what do you call this stuff? Raffia? I think so. I'm having a mind blank. It's late at night here. And I went with that instead. So I shoved that, and then you can see I already did my arrangement off camera. Put that around, secured it on the back. Not rocket science here. You guys can figure this out. Be creative. Do whatever you want. You could use some jute there. I picked up these little mini pumpkins or wood pumpkins from the Dollar Tree as well. They came with like tiny, tiny little jute strings that were so cute. So I used that to tie it on. Oh, I painted this pumpkin like a yellow color off camera that just used a chalk paint from Waverly. And now I'm taking a pencil and just drawing the lines. And you'll see me take out my sandpaper again because I love distressing stuff. Here we go, I'm just distressing that. No more distressing. I love using sandpaper, how about you? It's so satisfying. That's my ripped up sandpaper. Okay, and then I'm just attaching it to that raffia. That's what we're calling it right now. Sorry, my head and hat, that's my favorite hat. I wear it like every day, my Patagonia hat. That's why I don't have to do my hair. All right, so anyways, there's my finished product. And thanks for crafting with me. If you're interested in learning more about Magnolia Design Company stencils, definitely hit me up. I'd love to share these incredible products with you. All right, talk to y'all soon. Bye.